Well, friends and family, we're gathered here today to join Matthew and Emily in the bonds of holy marriage.
My bride, the day and the hour is upon us. Before God, our family, and our community, we are making a covenant. I couldn't be more excited. There is no one else I would rather do life with, serve the Lord with, and make crazy and adventurous memories with. God has brought us together for His great purpose and our good. On this day, my prayer is that heaven delights and celebrates alongside us, that angels weep in excitement that you and I are together, and that Satan trembles at the thought of us doing mission together. For we are making the most holy covenant we can under heaven. I hope you know God is excited.
Dear Matt, today is the day we've been waiting for. You remind me constantly of God's grace and sovereignty in my life. Matthew Rahelia, you are my best friend and greatest comfort. There will be times during our marriage where we will try to do this on our own strength, but I pray we remember that God is for us. We don't have to muster up the strength to live the Christian life in our own power. There is more, so much more, that is ours in Christ. Even mundane realities like dishes, financial setbacks, strained family relationships, fear, and disappointments. They are simply the platform from which our God can display His mighty grace towards us.
Know, Emily, that I'm not perfect, for I still sin. However, I will spend my life serving you with all my might and vigor I can muster, all the while drawing on the power of grace to do so. I shall be patient and gentle with you when you're sad or anxious, not pressure you to feel a certain way, and guard in your heart for as long as we both shall live. I know that you're not perfect too. However, in any imperfect moment, I know that's not you. It can't be, because you are no longer an Adam. You are no longer condemned. You are in Christ Jesus, and He has already paid for your sins, past, present, and future. So I will look at you the way your Heavenly Father looks at you, as Jesus. I will look at you as a daughter of Christ, unafraid to cry, Abba, Father, and remind you constantly of the identity our good Father has given us. Because of these great truths, let's have fun, Emily. Let's live the most adventurous, God-glorifying, crazy lives we can muster. Let Satan host the celebratory dining service when we depart from the fields of battle because we can't continue fighting. Let those who don't know Him be implored by us to come to heaven. Let us be on our hands and knees daily praying for one another. Let us know all shall be well, and let us be reminded that someday God will wipe away every tear from our eyes. Let's get married, Em. Your undeserving groom, Matthew Ray.
Matt, you have made me a better woman. You have centered me on grace that only Christ can provide. You're knowledgeable and kind and so caring. Throughout dating, you have been Jesus to me when I needed it most. Through those summer months when dark days were many and light days were few and far between, you remained with me. You stood by my side and loved me patiently. I could write all day about how special you are, but I don't have that kind of time because, big surprise, I am late. I can't wait to marry you, and I vow to remind you that we need to reside in God and not do this on our own strength, but live freely in the life Jesus died on the cross for. I vow to choose you and to choose to love you on hard days and easy days. I love you so much, and I can't wait to finally be Mrs. Haley. Love, your bride, Emily.
I now pronounce you husband and wife. Matthew, you may kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my joy to introduce Matthew and Emily Haley.